Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam. You know when you're looking at all those super sexy renders on internet where images look so fresh, extremely detailed and almost touchable? Well, today I'm gonna share a final kick that professional industry uses to boost details in their images to add that extra realism with two sharpening methods, which are downscaling and high-pass sharpening. So let's jump into the first method, and that is downscaling. Let's first understand what downscaling is. Downscaling is basically resizing of an image. So, I need to render this image in 2000 pixels width, but what I did, I rendered it in 4000 pixels. So, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna just downscale this image from 4000 to 2000 using a resampling method called B-cubic sharper reduction. You can choose from various different types and just see which one works best for you. Now, straight out of the box, you can see the difference that this method produces. For example, you can see that all these grouts are already nicely visible. Now, you would think to yourself, why is this a better option? Why don't I just add some Sharpen and that's it? The thing is, when you render a 4000 pixel image in this case, or twice the resolution, your render automatically sees much more details and understands better what's going on in your image. And when you downscale it to 2000, as in this example, you are preserving a lot of these details into your image, and because of that, your image pops out. Now, let me compare. How did the 4000 downscaled image compare to the originally 2000 pixel rendered image? In this example, I have my 4000 pixel image, which was downscaled to 2000, and I have a 2000 pixel image, which was originally rendered in 2000 pixels. Now you can already see that something is changing in the scene. It's not the color, it's just everything pops out. So for example, if I zoom in to my tab here, you can see when I compare it to the originally rendered 2000 pixel image, you can see that much more things are jumping up. Take a closer look to this black line or this dark line happening in the middle of the tab, and look, on the 2000 pixel image, you actually don't see it, maybe a little bit on the top. But if we go to the 4000 pixel image, and when I look at what's happening in that image, you can actually see that the 4000 pixel version actually detected this detail, where the originally 2000 pixel image didn't detect that detail, but the downscaling method preserved it. Now, this effect is happening globally on your scene on every detail. You can even notice all these broken reflections here, how they look much more pronounced. Your whole image will pop out and it will feel much more fresher, and everything will have that touchy feelable feeling. Let's look at this wood texture here. So a wood texture that is downscaled. Now look what happens when I switch the downscaling off. You can see that all these grains are lacking a lot of detail. So for example, if you look at here and just look what happens when I turn on downscaling. All the details jump out. You can even see all these dots in the concrete. Everything jumps out. And like I said, this is a thing that happens globally on your whole image. And that's what makes your image pop out more and look much more nicer when your client looks at it. But if you don't want to render your images in double resolution, as that sometimes can be really time consuming, there is a high pass sharpening method. So what you do, you take your originally rendered image, right click, convert it to smart object, go to filter, other, and there you have high pass. Now when adjusting high pass, so you are literally watching which part of the image are going to be affected by the sharpen. So you want to have all these lines showing really thin like I have right now. By default, you're probably going to get something like this or whatever, but let's just keep it really thin, because that is a way to go. So when you click OK, you get that image, but now you have to click here on this little slider, and there you'll be changing the strength of your sharpen by four blending options. The softest option is soft light, then we have overlay, then we have hard light, and for the strongest sharpen effect, you have linear light. So let me show you what it does. I'm gonna choose overlay, for example. Okay. Now, if I zoom in into the image, look at the effect that's going on. You see, without, with, So if I change this, if I click again, and I change this to linear light, for example, my image is going to be mega sharp, as you can really tell. Now, if I go to soft light, it's going to be a soft sharpening effect. Overlay is going to be a little bit stronger. Hard light is going to be much stronger, and linear light is going to jump out like crazy. So let's stick to hard light, or no, overlay, for example. Okay, so we are getting a similar effect to the 4K version. So this is 4K and this is high pass. So 4K, high pass. But what is the main difference? If we go to our tap again, 4K preserved that line and all those additional details, where high pass is working only with the original image. So if I, for example, crank this up to a linear light, we're never gonna see that strong line here, but our image will definitely pop out. Let me change this to hard light for now. As you can see, it looks almost the same. The only difference is downscaling will preserve much more accurate details. But like I said, this really depends on how much time you have and if you can render that extra double resolution. That's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. Enjoy your sharpening, know what to sharpen and how to sharpen, and see you in the next video. Bye.